Hello guys and welcome back to a brand new video. Today, I bring the HK MP7, probably my most ambitious and successful project yet, and without a doubt, my favorite. So, without further ado, let us get started. The MP7 was produced in 1999 as a personal defense weapon to chamber the 4.6x30mm cartridge to meet the new NATO requirements published in 1989. And because of its success, it went into production in 2001 and has since then seen many iterations like the MP7A1 and the recent MP7A2. Personally, I still think the LEGO version falls short of the real gun, but it still has a wide variety of features to play around with. Aesthetic-wise, the gun includes a 3-stud wide rails on the two sides, but unfortunately not the top. The gun is almost completely smoothed out with flat tiles except for the top rails, which were built using the usual method. It's inaccurate, but it's the most piece-efficient way of building it, and my pieces were lacking near the end of this project. A lot of the dimensions and width changes were quite harsh on the stability of the gun, but it stays together extremely well. Everything from the arch above the fire selector to the slope front of the gun were made as close as possible to the real model. However, the magazine is quite possibly the ugliest thing you will ever see, but the curvature does look really nice when it's in the gun. It can be easily modified from the 20-round magazine to the 40-round and vice versa. And finally, the sights, of course, flip up and down using a hinge brick. Most of the moving parts on the gun are highlighted by the dark gray accents, such as the foregrip with the working lock, and the adjustable stock, which has the locking mechanism seen on the real gun, instead of the more commonly seen LEGO version with the pin piece. The safety works, and you can see how by the space behind the trigger, but unfortunately there is no trigger safety, which I would have liked to include, but there wasn't enough space in the body of the gun due to the bolt catch. The charging handle is separate from the bolt like the real gun, and it's fairly accurate, but it's not the most smooth because of the mechanisms inside. The bolt catch was pretty heavily based on Karo or Extreme Guns' design, which I will link in the description. Without his pre-existing MP7, I probably would have no way of tackling this project and would have built an extremely overcomplicated version of what I have now. It works the way it's meant to, but it's not exactly the most reliable. Sometimes the bolt will get jammed if the mechanism doesn't reset properly, but that's easily fixable by just pulling on the charging handle a couple times. And finally, what's become the norm for most of my guns now, the field strip. This one is especially difficult because of the bolt catch, but I was able to produce a reliable design in the end. The unfortunate part though, is that the rubber band is attached to the main body of the gun. Because of the lack of space in the gun with the stock and the bolt catch, I couldn't add an extra bar to the stock piece to attach the rubber band to, so that the entire mechanism would be independent from the gun. However, it still works amazingly, and honestly, I love how this gun turned out. But that's basically it. This build really is just a huge accomplishment for me, I feel. With all these features and just the aesthetic part of the gun, everything, I feel like I've stepped up a notch on my channel, which is what I want to do. Again, thanks to Extreme Guns for his MP7, because it was a good starting point for me to kind of look at to go about building this gun, because when I got suggested this by Christopher Hotman, I had no idea how to start. So, yeah, credits all given out, blah blah blah. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys next time. Goodbye, my friend. Hey, did you notice the script?